Hello guys, today's video will be about how to install and how to use the Substance Painter labeling with Maya. So let's get started. Once you download the zip file and extract it, you'll find a folder like this one. To install the plugin, you need to open the Substance Painter folder and copy the HH Connect folder to the Allegorithmic plugin path that is usually located in Documents, Allegorithmic, Substance Painter, Plugins. Now, when you open Substance Painter, the plugin will be available, as you can see here. Inside the folder you downloaded, you will find a folder called Maya. Open it and copy all the content except the menu.txt file. Then you need to paste it in the Maya Scripts folder, usually located in Documents, Maya, the year version, Prefs, Scripts. After that, open the menu.txt file and copy all the contents of the file. Then in Maya, click the button in the lower right corner to activate the script editor. Create a new mail script and paste the content of the file. Now click File, Save Script to Shelf, and give it a name. If you click the new button, the plugin should be working. Don't forget to save the shelf to keep all the changes after closing Maya. To use the plugin in Maya, you have to click the shelf button we created, set a port and click Start Listening. This will allow Substance Painter to communicate with Maya. Now, to use the plugin in Substance Painter, first we need to configure it. To do it, we click the plugin icon in Substance Painter and a window will appear. At the top, we have a pin button. If clicked, the window will always be on top of the UI. Then, we have the output path. Here, we choose the export path for the maps that will be generated by Substance Painter. In software we choose Maya, and a new option will appear called UDIMs. If enabled, the texture sets from Painter will be treated as UDIM textures and the materials created in Maya will also be configured to work with UDIMs. Then we have the port parameter. This port number must match the ones you defined in Maya. Then we have the renderer. At the moment, the plugin supports 4 different material types: Arnold, Redshift, Renderman, and Vray. It's worth noting that if you're going to use Renderman, you need to have installed the Arman3 external environment variable. This is needed to create the text file automatically by using the txmake command. You can find a guide on how to install the variable in the description. Then we can define the export resolution, the file format, and the normal format. All the renderers use OpenGL by default. If by any specific reason you need a DirectX normal map, the plugin will automatically flip the white channel in the shader to get the correct result when rendering. Then we can choose to either use one texture file per material map or optimize the textures and pack more than one material map in a single file. For example, use the same file for the occlusion, metalness, and roughness. Finally, we can select a bit depth of the normal and hide map, and a general bit depth for the rest of the maps. To send the textures to Maya, we have two options: either send all the texture sets or send only the currently active texture set. In this case, I'll click Send All. And the new material is created in Maya. With the idea of keeping the plugin flexible, since there are a lot of possible workflows, the plugin requires for you to assign the material the first time. So we assign the material, and there you go, it's working. Now if we change anything in Substance Painter and send the textures again, we'll be able to see the updated material in the renderer. Well, that's all for now. If you have any doubts or requests, let me know in the comments or via our Discord server.
Good luck!